Welcome to this evening's organ meditation from Jesus College Chapel. Today's service features a musical depiction of Jesus' life, conceived from improvisations performed in one of the organist and composer's visits to the United States. Marcel Dupré's Passion Symphony was completed some 3 years later. Some of the musical themes Dupré draws on might be familiar. Adeste Fideles is one example. The readings this evening also reflect on the story of Christ's incarnate life, from the world which awaits the coming Saviour to the jubilant celebration of Jesus' resurrection from the dead. Let us pray. In the name of Christ, who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light, grace to you and peace. Brothers and sisters in Christ, in this season of Lent, we prepare for the observance of our Lord's Passion and Resurrection with a time of penitence and fasting. As we meditate on God's word through readings and music, may we respond to the call for repentance, hear again the assurance of forgiveness proclaimed in the gospel, and so grow in faith and devotion. Let us pray for all God's people across the world and join with them in words our Saviour Christ has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Thank you.
In the Days of Caesar by Waldo Williams, translated by Rowan Williams. In the days of Caesar, when his subjects went to be reckoned, there was a poem made, too dark for him, naive with power, to read. It was a bunch of shepherds who discovered, in Bethlehem of Judah, the great music beyond reason and reckoning. Shepherds, the sort of folk who leave the 99 behind so as to bring the stray back home. They heard it clear. The subtle assonances of the day dawning toward cockcrow, the birthday of the Lamb of God, Shepherd of mortals. Well, little people and my little nation, can you see the secret buried in you that no Caesar ever captures in his lists? Will not the shepherd come to fetch us in our desert, gathering us in to give us birth again, weaving us into one in a song heard in the sky over Bethlehem? He seeks us out as word hoard for his workmanship, the laureate of heaven.
Thank you.
Agony by George Herbert. Philosophers have measured mountains, fathomed the depths of seas, of states and kings, walked with a staff to heaven, and traced fountains. But there are two vast, spacious things, the which to measure it doth more behove. Yet few there are that sound them, sin and love. Who would know sin, let him repair unto Mount Olivet. There shall he see a man so wrung with pains that all his hair, his skin, his garments bloody be. Sin is that press and vice which forceth pain to hunt his cruel food through every vein. Who knows not love, let him assay and taste that juice which on the cross a pike did set again a broach. Then let him say if ever he did taste the like. Love is that liquor sweet and most divine, which my God feels as blood, but I as wine. Sunrising by Sylvia Townsend Warner. Early one morning, in a morning mist, I rose up sorrowful and went out solitary and met with Christ. I knew him instantly, for his clothes were worn, carpenter's gear he carried, and between us was growing a winter thorn. For leaf and blossom, it had drops of dew. For birdsong, silence, more lovely, more innocent tree never grew. Give me, said I, and my hands forlorn held out, be it only one of these dewdrops hanging on the thorn. Of all these dewdrops hung betwixt you and me, that must die at daybreak, I own not one of them my own, said he. Hearing him speak thus, each dewdrop shone, enfranchised diamond, and with sun rising, all was gone. Gracious God, Creator Spirit, in the making of music, you have given us a delight for the mind and a solace for the heart. By the harmonies of your grace, resolve the discord of our lives, that we may show forth your praise in all we do and all we are, for the glory of your great and wonderful name. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, evermore. Amen.